Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube. If you've been watching the previous videos, you'll remember how I originally had a long staging area, but because I wanted it scenic, I started making a yard scene, and there's a couple videos on it. But I got halfway through and I decided, you know what, there's still one more scene that I want to recreate, so I'm going to split this area in half. I'll still keep the one half as North Bessemer Yard, although condensed, and the other side is going to be McKeesport. So let's see how I do it. I've done videos in the past about making scenic dividers using hardboard. I love this method. Now, this scene is only 12 inches deep, maybe about 11 inches tall at the most. So I had to cut it down and make sure that I had room to run the trains through. Now, if you look closely, see how that's just like a half inch taller than the backdrop? I did that on purpose because I'm going to have to cut into the foam. That's why another reason why I love to use foam on the layouts is I just drew a line and cut out into the foam enough to put my scenic divider in. And if it's nice and snug, perfect. I also tested, make sure my tallest boxcar would run through with no problems. And it's plenty of clearance on both sides. So the big question is, how do you blend this in? Now, I've used realistic backgrounds in the past, and you just simply spray the back of the paper with spray glue. And it's not perfect, but it does the trick over here. Now, I am making a rolling mill scene, and I happen to have HO rolling mill unassembled. And that's what I'm going to use for this. So on this side, we're going to use the rolling mill, and I'll have to cut out where the train's going to cut through. This will be the McKeesport scene. And on the other side, I glued the same. Yeah, I'll have to do a little bit of fixing up. But this is going to be the North Bessemer scene, and I'm going to blend that all in with the turnpike. And for the rest of this video, we're just going to stick to the McKeesport side and see how much we can get done. I'm using 5 sections of the Walther's HO rolling mill. One of the ends I put on the track and marked to see where the tracks go through, and cut it just enough that the trains fit through perfectly. Now the other 4 pieces I glued together using a long piece of strip styrene and painted the whole thing white. I also cut out for garage doors and other doors for people. And then I'm going to make a road along here and kind of fix up this area back here. The pink foam is where I'm going to eventually build a brick building. Here, let me show you what I did. This is just simple long styrene, and that holds it all together. I made this access road, but I forgot to hit record while I was making it. It is done with blue painter's tape and joint compound. But relax, I've already made a video years ago on how to make a road with a joint compound. This is no different. Now, the next day I came down, and when it dried, it must have been too thick because you see all these cracks in it. So I just simply go over with another layer, nice and easy, and I use my finger just to smooth it out. When the joint compound's like mostly dry, that's a good time to just take a blade or something and kind of cut for the railroad wheels flanges to fit through. And when it's all done, you just want to sand it down with very fine sandpaper. So this is not the main road into the building, so I'm going to allow some of the imperfections. I think that's going to give it some character. But here you see I'm just kind of adding another layer of it. Just very smooth with the finger, and we're going to let it dry. When it's totally dry, that's when you can remove the blue painter's tape. Using a foam brush and some acrylic paint, I painted the road. My first attempt was with just a solid gray. I didn't really like it too much. I ended up going over a lot of it with my own blend of black and white. The rolling mill decals. Actually, that's just paper that I printed images off the internet and spray glued the back of the paper and onto the building. For a 3D force perspective on the roof, I'm using blue painter's tape. Now let me remove the building here, kind of show you what I got to work with. Now remember, this was a yard scene that I'm working over top of, so that's why the background was already painted previously. So a little bit of a challenge. Now I put the blue painter's tape and I paint downward. And I add some color. What I'm going to do is use black and brown and paint at a downward angle the way that I think the roof would be. And I'll tell you, paint away from the tape. I've made some mistakes while doing this. If you paint up towards the tape, you'll end up getting paint under the tape. So my first attempt wasn't perfect. But through trial and error, a lot of blue masking tape, I think the roof came out really nice. This is all just kind of knowing where you want to make your angles to give you that forced 3D perspective. I think this looks really good. I used this foam mounting tape, just a couple pieces on the back of the rolling mill to attach it to the wall. And I ran the train through just to see how it looks together. Now remember, this rolling mill is that large in real life. So to scale, yes, this is looking pretty realistic. One thing that I'm doing is called creative liberties, and that means basically, hey, like someone else said, it's my railroad. This doesn't have to be identical to the prototype, and I don't expect it to be, but it's going to be close enough that you recognize where you're at. I'm modeling 1980s, back when this was still under United States Steel. Right now it's owned by Durabond. On the prototype, there is one track that goes into the building over here, and the rest, the tracks go into the building from behind. So yes, creative liberties, have fun with it, and make whatever you want. Other cool things I'm going to model will be the guard shack. This is back from the United States Steel days. I'll have to make that police station, which you see there, and also the parks. McKeesport Daily News. And then the big brick building is going to have to wait till I can get some of that brick sheet. So I hope you like this video. Subscribe and hit that bell icon. That way you can be notified of the future videos. All right. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. And see you soon.